Hi everyone, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. Welcome back if you are a subscriber, and if you are not, hi there for the first time, I guess. So in this lesson, I want to talk about what I call as hybrid skills. So what you heard in the beginning in that performance video had basically these hybrid skills or many skills put together in order to showcase not just one of the sixths or not just one of the thirds or so on and so forth. I'm trying to toggle, I'm trying to interact between the intervals, right? I'm not just saying I will play my music on a major third because it's a major scale. I could also look at a minor third, or I don't have to look at a major seventh all the time. I can look at a minor seventh, right? So that's the concept of hybrid scales. If you haven't already, it'll be great if you can consider subscribing to our channel and hitting on that bell icon for notifications. That'll be very, very helpful for our channel to grow. So let's get cracking with hybrid scales. So if I take the key of A, and I'm very clear when I say the key of A, that means A is the root of the scale. But I didn't say the scale of A, because there are many scales from A, but there is only one key, which is the A key. Well, there are actually 12 keys, but you can build many scales with respect to the A key. And by many, and you take Carnatic music, you have 72 Melakarta ragas, which are a lot to deal with. Okay, I'm going to build a scale now, A major. Now A major, well, it has a root, a major second, a major third, perfect fourth, perfect fifth, major sixth, major seventh, octave. Now you could also do, basically you have two kinds of sevenths available in music, right? At least Western music, which is major seventh and the minor seventh. So people use that from time to time. That's also called as the mixo or the mixolydian scale. So if you develop a lick, so phrase one has that major seventh, phrase two, that's like more of a brave answer. It's almost like two people are talking to each other, right? Two characters or two personalities just built by the interaction of a major seventh and the more stronger or the more powerful dominant seventh, minor seventh, another way we can call it. Let me try and explain that again. That's your flat seven. Major seventh. Find the Beatles doing it in a few of their songs. Or section one of the Beatles song. That flat seven at the second part of the of Hey Jude, right? With a little help is again May major in the beginning. Mixolydian or flat 7 at the chorus. So another thing I like to talk about when it comes to hybrid scales is how you can even mess around with the third, as absurd as that may seem. You know, how can you, you know, play a major and a minor scale in the same song? Well, sounds quite beautiful actually. So if you take the A key, the C sharp becomes the major third, the C becomes the minor third. So you have, so if you begin a phrase like, so you're kind of ascending. And end on the root. I like that. Minor third. If you observe, I'm even playing around with the sixth. I'm doing like my minor sixth, minor third in my right hand and minor sixth in my left hand. Make some hope now. Major sixth, right? So you can play minor sixth and major sixth together. Minor little bit more on the gloomier side, or the more, I guess, sadder side, serious side. Now, hopeful, that's the other sixth. In the A major, major sixth, F sharp, minor sixth, which will be a bit more weighty, lot more grander, lot more epic, the major sixth. So if I start in my right hand with a minor third and play around with the sixths in my left hand, get some nice color. Very pensive, very melancholic, I guess. Lot of a struggle going on with that minor sixth. Some hope. Major. In fact, we call this the Picardy cadence in an otherwise minor song. You end on a one major and just brightens up suddenly. So in this piece which I've composed called Onward Bound, I've done the major third with the major sixth, and then immediately playing with the two sixths. The major sixth, minor sixth, sticking with the major third, major. Now I'm coming, slipping to minor. Bass changes. There we have it. With a flat seven. Major seventh, come back to the flat seven. So with this entire production, you should probably hear the actual song. We'll put it up in the description of the video. I'm playing with the major seventh, the minor seventh, playing with the major third, minor third. I'm playing with the major sixth, minor sixth. So this is what I in essence call as a hybrid scale. It's not major, it's not minor, it's not mixolydian. It's all of them, right? So that's what I mean by hybrid. So in my mind, the flat 3, normal 3, major 3rd, minor 3rd, as simple as that. The major 6th, minor 6th. The major 7th, minor 7th. Emotionally, Major third's very positive, minor third's a bit darker and a bit more sadder, gloomier. Major sixth, grander, epic. Minor sixth, very mysterious, very James Bond-like, very, you know, sneaky also. Major seventh, lot of tension in there, it's like waiting to resolve. Dominant seventh, lot of weight, very brave, very epic again. So why not play with all of them in one song, like how people make, well, a story or a movie, right? We have all the changing emotions. So if the third, the sixth and the seventh color up the sound so much, why not just use all of them if your song demands it? So that's about the hybrid scales. I'd like to conclude my study of the, my discussion rather, on the hybrid scales by just giving you a little bit on what I call as the hybrid minor. I would love to talk about that in detail in another lesson, but for now, the hybrid minor is where you have a minor third always, but then you have four minor scales which you can play around from the top end of the scale. The sixth and the seventh can permute themselves in various ways. So you could do natural minor, which is a flat six and a flat seven. Then you can have what we could call as the harmonic minor, which is a flat six and raised or major seventh, all with a home base being a minor third or a minor home chord. Natural, Aeolian, harmonic. Then you could even have Dorian, what we all call as Dorian. So Sa Re Ga Ma Pa remains the same. Major sixth, minor seventh, obviously octave. And you have one more minor part of the whole hybrid combo. And this merging of minors has happened. You've all heard this song. Yeah. La da 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 dee. The melodic minor, where he's climbing his melody, then he's coming down, which is pretty much how the classical interpretation of the melodic minor is in the first place. You go up with a raise 6, raise 7, and when you go down, go down the natural minor. So there are four hybrid minor scales to deal with: natural, harmonic, Dorian, and lastly melodic. All having different flavors, right? You've done some stuff with the 3, the 6, and the 7 in this lesson. What about the other stuff? What is the other stuff? Well, you have the root, which you can't change. You have to be in the key of something for the most part. And you need the fifth, generally to create stability and to make you understand what's going on. So root and fifth in most cultures, East and West, don't change at all. That leaves us with the 2 and the 4. Now that, I don't call them as hybrid scales. I call them as exotic scales. So whenever you have your 2 and the 4 altered, in other words, you do not have the major 2, instead you have the minor 2. So if you take major and add the flat 2 instead of the major 2, this feels to me, I just give it that word, exotic. An exotic place or an exotic fruit or a vegetable, if you are into that stuff. Flat 2, I consider exotic, or a sharp 4, which is a raised 4, or you could call it augmented 4, or it's just a tritone, really, with the 5. So, very dreamy, very surreal. So, that's why I like to give it very an an exotic name. So in my book, when I'm combining scales, I tag them primarily as hybrid scales, which mess with the 3, major 3rd, minor 3rd, the 6th, major 6th, minor 6th, the 7th, major 7th, minor 7th, and the exotic stuff or the flavor comes from the flat 2 instead of the major 2, and the sharp 4 instead of the perfect 4th. Normal? Exotic. I've used this concept in so many of my riffs that when I broke it down and when we classified it with some amazing students as well who helped us put it out in one unified website. So the website is called riffs.jasonzachmusic.com. You should head over there. We've basically catalogued all of my riffs and used some very interesting musical tags to it. Not just the genre. Well, there is genre, there's emotion, which I think is quite interesting. You should check that out. You could filter by genre, emotion, and musically you can filter by scale, by key, by time signature, by time feel, which is another interesting character rhythmically. But when you go over to the melodic stuff, you can filter by scale or key, and forget about key. If you go there with scale, what you'll find is you'll have an array of scales to choose from, and there is some things which even I brand as the hybrid minor or hybrid in general or exotic. You'll find those words there. So do check it out. Tell me what you think. Try and learn some of those riffs. I'm always available on Instagram if you'd like to tag me, or if you'd like to record a YouTube video and send it to us. It'll be awesome. So all the best with this. A lot of you have had this question about, you know, how do you make your riffs? Well, this is one of the concepts which I think I use, which is fairly unique to me. There are a lot of rhythmic concepts as well, so I will try and talk about it. But for the most part, this lesson covered this whole idea of hybrid scales. There's a link Onward Bound in the description. Do check that out. You'll find all of this. An amazing Veena player, Radhika Bhaskar, playing on the track. So do check out that song as well by my band. And that's about it, guys. If you haven't already, do consider hitting that subscribe button. There's a bell button as well. Hit that, please, for notifications. And whenever we put out a lesson, you'll get it. You could also consider joining a course, a very regular kind of course which we conduct at our music school. Either in person you can learn with me and the other faculty, depending on which instrument you'd like to learn. You could do a music method certificate course at a foundation level or at an intermediate level if you wish, or you can take up these regular videos which we've put out or will be putting out more regularly on our website, nathanielschool.com. Under that, head over to the video courses. So you could consider either doing a video course, doing an in-person kind of lesson with us or our faculty, or just continue watching these YouTube videos, and if that works for you, great. And there's also a Patreon page where you can support the channel. Do head over to Patreon. You'll get all my handwritten notes for each of my lessons, basically for $5 a month, which is not a lot of money, I think. So do head over to Patreon and help support the channel. Cheers, catch you in the next one.